Children's Able and Disabled Sports, known as CADS, is a unique sport and leisure experience for children of all abilities and backgrounds. The regular week-long event includes a vast range of sporting and physical activities, which are fully inclusive for able and disabled children respectively. The only divide at CADS Week is into different age groups. The weeks are organised with great attention to detail, with a timetable allowing maximum fun and experience for each participant. Every group takes part in 16 different activities through the week, spending an hour on each one. The CADS Weeks are designed to give the young people opportunities to participate in both familiar sports and try out new, more diverse activities too, from cricket to cup stacking, from golf to gymnastics.
At CADS Week we've been doing swimming, rock climbing,
basketball, netball, martial arts,
archery, swimming, climbing,
orienteering, cricket, hockey, lacrosse, athletics, football.
The week is rounded off with a group activity where the young people complete team exercises, working together to reach a goal. This is where the success of the week shines through, as new friendships and skills are evident, teamwork especially. During the afternoon, everyone involved gathers in the marquee for a presentation ceremony to celebrate the success achieved by all of the young people throughout the course of the week. Everyone is recognised with a certificate, and two individuals from each group are rewarded with Best Contributor and Highest Effort awards. The atmosphere is extra special.
The child's new skills that he's developed are he's built more confidence, because there's a lot of children here, a lot of friends that is from last year and new friends from this year. And basically it's just a lot of confidence and to try all different things.
The CADS Weeks are hosted during the school holidays at the Royal School for the Deaf and Communication Disorders and at neighbouring school St James's. The former is a residential special school catering for young people with a wide range of different disabilities. The last 4 years have been a continual success for the project. It has now expanded to the two locations, and the participation of young people has gone from 100 to 300, with 500 applicants this year.
The idea was initially formed 4 years ago when a colleague of mine and myself realised there was no sport, health or leisure activities available for severely disabled young people. So instead of just catering for them, we decided to get the entire community involved and have an inclusive activity where disabled and able-bodied young people can come and take part in these activities together.
The young people are made up of 5 to 16 year olds, around 45% of which are children with special needs. There are a number of essential contributors who make the week possible, and each one plays a crucial part. Besides the young people, each group includes high-quality coaches, trained volunteers, and a member of staff from the school. The members of staff are trained to deal with any behavioural issues and similar needs.
I do all sorts of sport. I do like basketball, and today I've been doing lacrosse and hockey, and I've been doing a lot of them.
It's really rewarding to be involved in CADS Week from a number of different angles. First of all, to see the young people that are involved in the week enjoying themselves. The comments from parents who, at the end of the day, their kids tell them they've had a great time. And also from volunteers who particularly enjoy the time here this week, and it gives them the opportunity to learn new skills and be in a completely different environment than anything they've been used to before.
It has been proven that a major part of the success come from CADS' growing reputation and parents' recommendations to friends. The Royal School for the Deaf and Communication Disorders has established a clear ethos for CADS. This is about providing the best possible opportunities for young people from any background to take part. Extra measures are provided, including complimentary transport for children otherwise unable to attend.
I've run the Stockport Disability Database for 10 years. I visit every family in their own home. I gather information about the needs of those children. I knew all these children needed this service because I had the database and because I've spoken directly to parents. When I'm with those families, I also try to empower them as much as possible to ensure that they know exactly what's out there for them.
The CADS Week is about inclusion, integrating different young people into new environments, community spirit and awareness. It's about trying to create possibilities for young people and inspiring them.
The kinds of skills that the children developed over the years are making friends, being able to mix with other children well. They find new interests, so my eldest son came across archery, which he really loves, and they get to meet new children, get to play. It's nice that they're both abled and disabled children here, because it's good for our kids to mix with children of all different abilities and facing different challenges.
The benefits of the event are endless. Ultimately, the week provides a chance for involvement and social interaction, and is a fantastic way of improving self-esteem, particularly in children with disabilities who may not have had such opportunities before and had little confidence before coming. It is highly rewarding for the young people when they're commended at the end of the week, particularly for those who found some areas challenging. It is promoting relations between children of all different abilities and helping non-disabled children to realise that children with disabilities have an equally valuable role to play.
Well, some of the sports that you do, like basketball, well, like last year we did like basketball in wheelchairs, and I thought that was quite challenging because you get to see what like disabled people are like as well.
Many of the children attend with brothers and sisters with disabilities and vice versa. This is an opportunity for them to do something collectively. It is very rewarding to see siblings enjoying the activities together, often for the first time. The positive outcomes from the integration of the different young people are helping them to understand each other from an early age. It is helping to avoid the common misconception of people with disabilities and helping to create a more positive and accepting community, which the young people will take into later life.
I think it is so important, especially for normal children, to meet special needs children, because there's a sort of stigma attached to them. And in many ways, they think they cannot integrate, cannot mix and become friends, but obviously it's proved to be not the case when they come here, and you know, they can go back to school and tell the other friends about special needs children.
Some of the young people learn some basic sign language throughout the week and seem to relish the opportunity of communicating with the deaf children. The development of communication between the children is remarkable. The coaches at CADS Weeks are from a number of varied backgrounds. There have been many different coaches with disabilities, including a gymnastics coach with Down syndrome and a tetraplegic tennis coach, both of which have represented their countries at the highest level. This can only have an encouraging effect on the young people. It is presenting them with the possibilities and opportunities through positive role models.
Teaching children of varied abilities is a challenge for a coach, but that's why I think makes a good coach, being able to cope with the situation that you have and then making sure that the kids get enjoyment out of it. If the kids walk out with smiles on their faces, we've done our job, and that's all that we want to do our job.
I think that like working alongside disabled coaches and disabled athletes not only gives me inspiration, but it gives me inspiration to give others inspiration as well.
I remember when I had my accident, I had people come in to see me, you know, because I thought I wouldn't be able to do anything, and people that came in that were successful in various fields. So, you know, it made me aware that opportunities were available and that I could be at success. So I think if you have been successful, then it is good to go in and speak to people and try and inspire them to achieve, because they can look at you and say, well, you know, it is possible because it's been done. So, you know, I really enjoy doing that.
The buzz and excitement of the week drives everyone involved to make it a huge success. It is the vision and dedication of the facilitators to achieve goals. Strong partnerships have really helped to drive CADS forward. Joining forces with St James's has allowed the expansion over the two sites. Support has been provided by Sport England's Active England programme via the Big Lottery Fund and sponsorship from local organisations. These are all helping to continually strengthen and improve the events.
I think the partnerships are involved. This isn't just about parents and children, although they are, they're the core. But it's the volunteers, it's Sport England, it's the Cheshire in as well. But it's those people together make it work. And it is very much a team effort. Only by us all working together can the whole succeed. And this has been a truly successful week. I've been hugely impressed, and it goes from strength to strength.
The links that we've made for CADS Weeks have been really important, because it wouldn't be able to run without them. We've got great partnerships with Greater Sport and Stockport Sport Development, and they've helped us with the coaches. Also the links with St James's School, we just wouldn't be able to do the event unless it was across two sites, because we just haven't got the facilities ourselves. Everyone in the area really mucks in and helps us out with it. It just wouldn't be possible otherwise.
The feedback from everyone involved in the project has been exceptional. Comments about the event have been so positive. The parents are excited by their children's development and learning, and the children are delighted with the new experience and all the friends that they make. It is clear to see at the end of the week the fun and joy that has been shared. Children are always seen swapping contact details with their newfound friends. The future aim of the CADS project is to get more organisations involved in the concept through different events that incorporate all types of young people. The community needs to see more opportunities and chances for all children to work and play together, regardless of ability. Whether it is week-long programmes, after-school clubs or sport-specific activities, there is the need for more quality volunteers and coaches to help improve young lives. There's no reason why more organisations should not take on board the idea, and the CADS team is looking to support this.
We just feel so lucky that my children and other children in the area can access this this event and become more aware that disabled children do like enjoying themselves and enjoying the same activities and facilities as more able-bodied kids. And if that were spread out more across the country, hopefully people would become more aware of the needs of disabled children and they just want to be as normal as possible and enjoy things like other kids do.
CADS continues to be a success and an inspiration for others to embrace. Fundamentally, it is providing grassroots level physical activity for young people. It is presenting chances to try things out to see if they like it. It is motivational and above all, fun, and helps develop social skills and learning. It's all about creating self-esteem and finding potential in children. CADS hopes to see more children benefiting from the idea and more schools, voluntary groups and local authorities helping to make it happen. Sport can be played by anyone and should be enjoyed by all.